Hey everyone, this is Balint, and today I'm answering Brian's question, which was, which is better, Integromat or Zapier? So as a quick recap, these tools are connectors, they connect apps, and you can synchronize data between them or have some sort of action. For example, this video was uploaded by Zapier because I put the video into a Google Drive and Zapier uploaded it to YouTube. Just a small example, but we concentrate on bots mainly, so that's why I put here on the left side just a couple of logos, because it's mainly the user does something and then the bot, which you have React, and then sends the data to Integromat or Zapier, and then something happens. Maybe it's a CRM that you use, maybe you get a notification, and maybe you want to send some data back, for example, from a Google Sheet or Google Calendar, or have a countdown, or there's so many opportunities here. I'm not going to go into details, but that's just a quick overview of how this software can help you. All right, so let's take an overview on what we're going to review today. And I would say let's jump into it. So the functionalities, both are very powerful. And I have to give it to Integromat because it's a little bit more advanced with what you can do. But I wouldn't say Zapier is not as clever. Zapier just has a different functionality. So let me just quickly go over what you have in Zapier. So you have all the apps as a trigger, and then you can use the built-in apps to do something with this. So for example, you can set up a delay if you want, you can translate the whole text into something, or create a webhook, which is very powerful for other or format things. So that's something that Zapier adds to the table. And if I go to Integromat, you have all these tools here as well. You can router, filter, ignore, set variables, and all these tools. And if you go into here, and let me just go here, for example, if I want to set an attribute, then I have all these possibilities inside of Integromat as well, so I can add numbers, or I can use something, for example, a timestamp, which you can do by Zapier as well. So both are these very powerful. If you have a specific functionality that you don't really know if you could do it, you have a better chance with Integromat, but I think you are covered with both of them quite well, all right? So the next point is, this is a image by a fellow bot builder, and this is by Integromat, just to see what you can do with these crazy web visual builders, so to say. So this is when the chat fuel bot sends some data, and you can route it to different places depending on what services or what leads it happens to be, and then send out notifications. Just crazy. Thank you for the image. All right, integration apps. Zapier has been on the market for quite a while, and it has over 1,000 integrations. And if I take a look at what Zapier offers, I don't think we have it, but yeah, the apps. This is what I have apps, but if you scroll down here, you probably find an app that you use in your marketing toolset. And which is not on Zapier, it's probably not that used in terms of automations, or they probably will add it to it, okay? One of the things that Zapier is better is ManyChat. If you use ManyChat, Zapier has a better native integration. For chat fuel, Zapier only has an action and no trigger. It's the other way around with Integromat, where, let me just get the, I don't have the apps, or Integromat has chat fuel added not so long ago. They actually haven't even updated the logo, but what they have is Let me just find a URL. All right, so here are the services by Integromat, and if you take a look, there are plenty of them, and many of the main big services that you use are here already, and they are adding more and more, and both of them have webhooks as well. So if you have the ability to add something extra from a software that doesn't have direct integration with them, then you can use that. With Chat Fuel, as of the bot builders, Integromat has a better native integration with the trigger function as well, but you can play around with both with the webhooks, so it's not a real issue, to be honest. So, usability. I have to give this to Zapier as well. It has a little bit cleaner interface, less room to failure, so to say. And I believe the learning curve is smaller. So you have a trigger and you can set the actions. It's quite linear. And also it's a little bit limited, more limited to compared to Integromat. But in terms of usability, that's what you have. You can just create what you want to have, like send a text message to the user. And if you have a trigger, it can be that the user reaches a certain point of the interaction in terms of the conversation on Messenger. And one other thing with Zapier is that you can, like, if you fail or didn't set up something correctly, it's a little bit more straightforward. With Integromat, according to my experience, even with others, that is a little bit more, like, tricky to figure out what's the issue here. But in a way, it's very straightforward here as well, so you don't have to worry about that much, to be honest. Next point is pricing or free plan, and here is the biggest difference, I believe, between the two software. Integromat has a way better free option, and also the pricing is a little bit friendlier. So let's take a look at what Integromat has to offer. Okay, so as you can see, there are 1,000 operations for on the free plan, and there is a data limit. So if you have images or something that is a bigger, then it's probably not the best, or you have to take care of this as well. Otherwise, if it's just little simple data, I wouldn't be so scared of this. And as you can see on the paid plans, it gets way bigger. And many of the interactions that we use with chatbots are instant, but this is how it goes down with the timing. So if it's something that you want to do it like once a day or something, then you don't have to be worried about like how often does it activate the system. And one thing which is a little bit tricky here is that if you have a something like a monitoring activity in a sheet, then it triggers every 15 minutes, for example, if you set to 15 minutes, compared to Zapier when it just only triggers, only counts as an operation if it triggers, if the sheet is changed. So let's take a look at Zapier's pricing. And as you can see, let's see, like the 29 per month has 40,000 operations. And if I go over to Zapier, if I find it here on my computer, then you can see that the, I don't have the free plan, but the free plan is limited to two actions. So you cannot have multi-step zaps. So it can be one simple trigger and one action. So it cannot be that you send back an answer. It cannot be that you have something booked and then you transform a whole data and then it's a different format. Let me just show you what I have here as an example. This is by a calendar application called 10 to 8, and this is not available on Integromat, so I have it here. And as you can see, there are quite a few steps here, and we just have to convert a date, we put it into a sheet, then we send it also back to the user confirmation, and we put them on a reminder sequence. It's working very well, and this is not possible on the free plan, but it's possible on Integromat if your calendar is integrated with it. All right, so That's another thing. And as you can see, for example, this 25 USD, it's not even close to the 40,000 interactions. Actually, it would also already need like a team action as well. So if you are a heavy user, the price difference is quite dramatic. All right. The next point is support, which I have various experiences with both of the software, and I heard positive from both sides. What I see as we chatbot builders that Integromat is a little bit more open to this, and they have some sort of support via Facebook now. They used to have a forum, and but with Zapier with paid accounts especially, it's very okay to get the answers. But I hear stories, so I never really satisfied with supports anyway. So I cannot give a thumbs up for, well, there are a few softwares I would give thumbs up, but these are none of them. All right, so overall, I would say it's a close matchup, and there are a couple of things if you consider that make Integromat a better option, and they will add ManyChat as well soon, so I guess the interactions and apps will be pretty much closer to the Zapier's one with a couple of months later as they expand. And if you are on a budget or consider the pricing options or the free plans, then it's a way better deal. And one of the things, a small tip I want to give you, is that you can use both of them. And you can use, for example, I showed you this calendar thing. I could do in a way that the calendar triggers a Zapier webhook, and then it takes over to Integromat, and Integromat plays this all actions. So there are things that you can do. It's just only your time and imagination that can limit you here. All right, guys, that's about it. Let me know in the comments which do you use, which do you like, what is your experience. I'm stoked to read these, and see you in the next video. Bye.